Hello, can everyone hear me? Yeah? So thank you so much for coming to this exhibition. The players really appreciate the support during this difficult time. So we have two professional squash players here today, ready to put on some quality squash for your guys. And we hope you enjoy it. After the match, there's going to be an on-court interview and some questions and answers. So now I'm going to introduce the players to court. First up, we have an outstanding squash player from Belgium. She is currently ranked 18 in the PSA World Rankings. In her last season, she reached the third round of the World Championships and the last 16 of the British Open. She also has two titles on the PSA World Tour. Please welcome Tina Helis. And her opponent today, I'm not really sure you guys know of her. She is currently ranked 52 on the PSA World Rankings. She is five-time Finnish champion and Finland's number one. This year, she reached the final of the Savcorp Finnish Open and the semi-finals of the Nash Cup. She's the local superstar. It's Emilia Soini. Good luck. You want to switch sides? Amelia Sawney to serve, Tina Helis to receive, best of five games, love all. One love from the left. Two love. And out, 1-2. Two all. Three, two. Two from the right. And out, 3-0. And out, 4-3. Stroke ball. Oh, let 4-3. Thank you. And out for all. And out, 5-4. And out, 5-5. Six, five. Seven, five. Yes, sir. And out, 6-7. And out, 8-6. And out, 7-8. Eight all. Nine, eight. Ten, eight, game ball. Game to Tina, 11-8. Leads one game to love. Tina leads one game to love, love all. Hand out, one love. Two love. Hand out, 1-2. Hand out, 3-1. Four-1. 5-1. And out 2-5. And out 6-2. Seven, two. Yes, sir. And out 3-7. Four, seven. Five, seven. Down. 6-7. And out 8-6. Down. 9-6. And out 7-9. Nine. Stroke ball. Hand out, 10-8, game ball. Hand out, 9-10, game ball. Game to Amelia, 11-9, games to 1-1. Games are 1-1, love all. Hand out, one love. Two love. Three love. Four love. Hand out, 1-4. Hand out 5-1. Six one. 7-1. And out 2-7. 8-2. And out 3-8. 9-3. 4-9. 10-4 game ball. 11-4, leads 2-1. Tinner leads 2-1. Love all. And out, one love. Two love on the left. Hand out, 1-2. Hand out, 3-1. And out, 2-3. Real. And out, 4-3. And out, 4-4. Five, 4. I couldn't see it, so can you play a lap, please? Six, four. Seven, four. And out 5-7. And out 8-5. Nine, five. On the right. 10-5 match ball. Game match to Tinna, 3-1. Well done, guys. That was a really enjoyable match. Really competitive. How does it feel to play a competitive match again?
It feels amazing. It's been like 5 or 6 months since I played my last competitive match, and it feels great. Just the feeling that you're back on court and like that you can give it your all, and start to fight for every point again. It's just an amazing feeling. So I really enjoyed this match.
And what about you, Amelia?
Yeah, I'm loud. It's been very enjoyable, especially playing against a world-class player like Tine. So definitely a special thing for me. And it's nice to kind of, even though it's an exhibition, but still we're doing this for a living, so we'll obviously still get our competitive side out for these matches. So it feels good, yeah.
What was going through your head at 2-1 down, trying to stay positive and change what happened?
Yeah, I was dying, to be honest. I've been doing a lot of fitness, but still, obviously, it's tough to play against someone who's ranked so highly in the world. But yeah, definitely still kind of trying to take the fitness side out, like work on it as well. Even though I'm feeling tired, I'm still trying to push for every point because it's still an opportunity to work on my fitness, even though I'm playing squash. At the same time, I did try to change a couple of things tactically, but I guess it didn't go too well.
And Tina, what do you think changed at 1-1 that led you to win 3-1 today?
Well, I have to say, I didn't try to change too much. I just wanted to enjoy being on court, as this was my first competitive match again, so I just wanted to enjoy it. And I know I play my best squash when I enjoy it more, so that's what I try to do. And I know, like, Emilia, she fights for every point. Like, it's hard to make a point against her because she won't give up. So I just try to execute my shots as good as possible every single rally, and I guess that's what worked.
Amelia, what was your prep like for today's match, and how do you usually prepare for a match in a tournament?
Today was funny because these two are staying at my little apartment, so we're prepping for the match all together, but we were singing karaoke, that's how we prepped. I'm not joking, but I was hitting in the morning with my coach, so it almost felt like I was in a tournament, because usually in tournaments we practice in the morning, we go on court for a little bit, like half hour or an hour, and then you go back to your hotel room or your wherever you're staying, you eat and you rest and you prepare for the match. And today I kind of felt the same way when we hit in the morning and went back and had lunch and then we were resting, and I was like super anxious watching what the time was and should I go to the club already? When's my match? Oh my God, oh my God. So I even told these guys that almost feels like a tournament. So that's kind of what we do and that's what we did today.
What did you find most difficult about playing Amelia today and when you play her in PSA?
Sorry.
What do you find most difficult about playing Amelia?
Well, Emilia has this very annoying game called lob and drop. And if you play against her on a glass court, it's even worse because of like the lights and stuff. So it's hard to see the ball. And you just have to make sure your shots are good enough so she cannot like hit her counter drop or whatever, because it's always so hard to get back. So I just try to stay out of her volley as much as possible and move her around so she cannot really use her strengths. So that's what I tried, and I mean that's the exact same tactic as I would use on the PSA tour. I mean, depends who you play, of course. You always have different tactics, but today this was my tactic, and I, thank God, God bless.
Amelia, have you enjoyed having us for the last month? And if you'd have one of us to stay again, who would it be, and why?
No, I've definitely enjoyed having both of you here. You guys were supposed to stay for like 10 days, but you ended up staying for almost a month. Obviously, at times, it's been a little crowded in the studio, but definitely it's been super fun to have you guys around and good times and good training and all that. And yeah, I forgot what the second question was.
Oh, okay. Tina, what would you say was your highlight being here in Finland for the last month?
Bubble tea. No, I really love bubble tea, and we've been going to this place for a few times, and I absolutely loved it. well, it's I like it like it's tea with milk, milky tea or fruity, whatever, and like you've got these bubbles. It's amazing. Anyway, I mean, apart from squash, because I mean, first of all, I would like to thank Sari for letting us using the courts and stuff, and Jaska for killing us for the good sessions. I learned a lot and I really enjoyed it, so thank you. And also to the Federation to let us join the camp and stuff. So thank you all so much for that. So that was definitely the highlight. Just I wanted to train well and have fun with some other pros and my friends. And I mean, that's what we did. So I really enjoyed my time here and I would love to come back.
Me too. Amelia, how's it been training over this period with no competitions, and how do you think you stay motivated throughout this?
I have personally enjoyed the corona break just because I'm a perfectionist when it comes to my squash and my training, and I still feel like I have a lot of things to improve on. So it's been nice for me to not have the anxiety to have only a certain amount of weeks to accomplish something. And then you have to go to a tournament, when I feel like now I've had kind of the peace of mind to work on certain things that I need to with my own pace. And I feel like I've done well in that. So for me, it's been nice, and I've been blessed to have the opportunity to still use these venues, use the squash club and use the gyms. I don't know if somebody's judging me for doing that, but whatever. But yeah, so for me, it's been quite nice to actually have a long period of time to just focus on my own training, my strengths and my weaknesses. And I still stay motivated. I'm quite competitive. So even though I'm in practice, like here it's an exhibition match, you know, you might have seen that I'm getting still quite frustrated when I'm not doing what I'm supposed to be doing. So I don't think motivation for me is a problem, even though I don't have tournaments yet. But definitely starting to feel like I'm getting ready for some match play again to see how I do against the better players after doing all this work.
And Tina, last question. You are now number 18 in the world. What do you think was the reason for your breakthrough and rise up the rankings?
Well, I have to say, since I moved to Nottingham last September, I improved a lot there because there are like more pros around to play against. And back home in Belgium, the only players I could compete against were all the guys, which is so different. Like the game is so different. So I think that's one of the biggest reasons why I improved. And I'm just also, I've got my best friend there as well. And like we're always lifting each other up. And it's just nice to be around like someone you can train with and someone you can hang out with. So it's just nice to be there. And the people there, they are lovely. I just love being there. So I think that's one of the biggest reason of my breakthrough, I would say.
Okay, and does anyone else have any other questions for the players? Anyone, ask now. Yes, when's your next tournament?
According to PSA calendar, they scheduled Manchester Open in September, I think the 15th, mid-September. So I'm kind of training for that at the moment. We're not 100% sure it's actually happening. But I like to think that it's happening so I have something to look forward to and I can train for that. So I guess that's the first tournament for us, hopefully.
Yeah. First of all, thank you very much for a very great match. And, you know, it's always nice to see when the professionals are playing top level squash. And thank you also for all those questions. Actually, you read all questions one can do. So what is left? My question is, I hope that you have many years to go in squash still. So what are your goals in squash? What do you want to achieve in your career?
Well, definitely go up in the rankings as much as possible. That's kind of vague, I guess, but definitely I've always wanted to be the best. I don't play to be average or to be just okay. I'm definitely thriving to be in the top of the ranking. So I guess that's my ultimate goal.
For me, I would say if I have to set a goal for example, next season, I would like to reach the top 15. But for long term, I would, of course, be the best in the world again. I would love to be world champion, world number one. That's what I'm training for, and I don't want less. So that's my goal.
Anyone else? Yeah. Well, thank you everyone for coming. I hope you enjoyed it. And thank you to you too.
And thank you all for coming. I really appreciate that. Thank you.